If you are about to end a relationship with a narcissist, you may be wondering how this person is going to react to you cutting the relationship off. In this video, I want to go over several different ways that narcissists can react to people trying to distance themselves or cut themselves off completely from a relationship they've been in. Welcome to Looking Behind the Mirror, where we explore narcissism and take our lives back as we make sense out of nonsense. As a quick disclaimer, everything I say is based on my opinions and my personal experiences. I'm not a professional, and if you're really struggling, I encourage you to seek professional help. I am providing links below for you. First of all, before I start going over the several different ways that narcissists can react, I want to stress that pathological narcissists are most dangerous when people are trying to break relationships off with them. More specifically, they are most dangerous when they are losing control of somebody that they once controlled. I can't stress this enough. You really may be shocked at what this person that maybe you think you've known for years or even decades is capable of. Pathological narcissists can be unpredictable, they can be absolutely ruthless, and nothing is more important to them than regaining control or doing whatever it is they need to do to feel relevant and important again. Their ego comes first, above anything else, and it may shock you to what lengths they will go to in order to, quote, win. So I just want to caution anyone that's about to break off a relationship with a narcissist, don't make the mistake of thinking, oh, well, he or she would never do that. He or she would never stoop to that level. I don't need to worry about that. I would advise you to be prepared for anything. Be prepared to protect yourself against the worst thing this person could possibly try to do. That being said, let's go straight into the most common reactions that we can expect when we're breaking off a relationship with a narcissist. The first one, of course, is going to be a big emotional apology. A big old come to Jesus moment where the narcissist suddenly realizes how good they've had it with you and what a fool they've been, and they suddenly seem to understand everything you've been trying to explain to them for maybe years. Suddenly it all makes sense to them. Suddenly they seem to be changing the things that you've been begging them to change for who knows how long. And they're probably shedding tears for you in front of you, declaring their undying love for you. They're saying all the things that you've been longing to hear. They finally seem to get it. This is a very common reaction in an abusive relationship when the abuse victim is trying to cut the relationship off. And of course, it's pure manipulation. If you need to threaten to leave someone to finally get them to appreciate you, if you need to cut the relationship off and destroy it before this person will listen or care about anything you've been trying to say, that's not a good sign. That's not real change. That's not a real apology. That's not anything real. That's manipulation, period. Somebody that really cares about you, that really appreciates you, isn't going to need you to leave them before they finally understand that. And if they really do, then they've got a lot of growing up to do before they are going to be anywhere near ready to be in a mature, meaningful, valuable relationship. What almost always happens in this kind of a scenario is you, the abuse victim, assuming that that's what you are, you finally hear all these things you've been longing to hear. You finally get this person to do all the just basic decent things you've been longing for them to do, and you give them another chance. You might even feel obligated to give them another chance because of how emotional they are and how sorry they seem. And you give them another chance and you let them back in, and things are really great for a couple weeks or maybe even a few months, and then the old habits creep back in. Maybe sooner, maybe later, but probably I would say within 4 or 5 months, things are right back to where they were before, if not sooner. And they're probably worse, because if you try to break things off with a narcissist and they have to like grovel to get you back, to get you to give them another chance, they now resent you for that, and they're going to punish you for that. They're going to make you pay for humiliating them that way. So if you give them another chance when they give you this emotional apology, fake apology, you're almost certainly going to end up in a worse situation than the one that you're already trying to escape from. Are there exceptions to this? I mean, people win the lottery. I don't know. People get struck by lightning. I am going to go out on a limb and say, in my opinion, no, there are no exceptions to this, in my opinion. Another reaction that you may see from narcissists that you're trying to break things off with is an attempt to regain control of you. Now, when a narcissist is emotionally apologizing and crying and promising to do better and telling you how much they suddenly realize they appreciate you, that is an attempt to regain control. But this regaining control can also happen in a lot of different ways. Another way that a narcissist might attempt to regain control would just be maybe to shame you, to guilt trip you, maybe to remind you of all the things that they've done for you. How can you leave them after everything they've done? How can you hurt them like this? How can you do this to their mom or their kids or their dog? How can you be so cold? They may try to scare you. Maybe they will suggest to you that you're never going to make it on your own. You're never going to be able to make anything of yourself without them, or you can't survive without them. There's all kinds of ways that narcissists can use emotional manipulation to regain control of you. And I think it's really important to remember that this is the most important thing in the world to them, is to regain control. And if they feel like they already control you and control your emotions, I mean, they might not even do anything. They might not even mind leaving if they have something better lined up. And I think I'll go over that in a minute. But if they feel like they already have control of you, then that's going to keep them calmed down and they're not going to be so preoccupied with trying to regain control. But it's important to realize that this is extremely important to them. Knowing that they continue to control the people that they once controlled is everything to them, and they will stop at nothing. So any kind of manipulation, any kind of shaming, guilt trips, anything they say to make you feel obligated, remember, anyone that abuses you and mistreats you does not have the right to have you in their life. It doesn't matter how much they've done for you. Nobody can buy the right to own you. Nobody can buy the right to mistreat and abuse you. There is no amount of favors, money, anything that anyone can do for you, no matter how much they've been there for you. There's nothing that anyone can ever do for you that makes it okay for them to treat you like crap. So don't let this affect you in that way. This is meant to manipulate you and make you feel like you need to stay with somebody that treats you like crap. And that is just never the case. That's never okay. If somebody really wants you in their life, they need to treat you right, period. Another very common thing that narcissists will do when you try to leave them is engage in a smear campaign. They will basically try to beat you to the punch before you can tell people all the awful things that they've been doing to you all this time. They'll just go around and tell lies about you, or they might even tell truths about you. Just maybe things that you are embarrassed, maybe things that you've confided in them. That can be a smear campaign as well. If they're going around saying things that you told them in confidence, or things that are really nobody else's business. Narcissists have no limits. They have no respect for your boundaries, and anything that you have told them in confidence is fair game. They will betray you any way they have to in order to be the one that comes out smelling like roses. So they could just go out and tell blatant lies, but it's a lot more effective for them to tell truths or to twist the truth, to spin things, to leave out the parts that make them look bad, to emphasize the parts that make you look bad. And unfortunately, 9 times out of 10, when a narcissist is engaging in a smear campaign, their story sounds a lot more reasonable than yours does. Their story is a lot more believable, because the way that narcissists treat people is truly unbelievable unless you've experienced it yourself. So This is really unfortunate that people that are hearing the narcissist story are probably going to be more likely to believe it than if you try to get in there and explain your side of things. And in my opinion, people that just believe the smear campaign, people that just dump you because of what the narcissist has said to them, those people are not people that were ever really your friend. Those people are not mature people. Those people are not people that have ever really been through something that has taught them that there are two sides to every story, and sometimes one side of the story is complete crap. Those are not relationships that were ever really worth anything in the first place. And I know it hurts. It still hurts to lose relationships that we thought meant something, but I think it's a lot healthier to let go of those relationships and recognize that they're not worth spending any more time and energy on. Another component of the smear campaign can be the narcissist trying to convince you that the smear campaign is what he says it is or she says it is. Narcissists can spend an enormous amount of energy trying to twist the narrative, trying to convince you that you are the bad guy. You are the one that messed everything up. Everything really is your fault. I was once in a situation where I was hearing many, many messages that basically in a very desperate tone kept saying, "Please, please, please forgive me for all the things that you did. I'm so, so sorry for how horrible you are." That's how it sounded to me anyway. And I think this is a really common way that narcissists can confuse abuse victims and make them feel that somehow it is all their fault and that the narcissist is like doing them a favor by allowing them to have another chance at being abused when really it was the abuse victim that left the narcissist in the first place. I don't know how they do these things, but the smear campaign is for everybody, and its main goal is to make sure that the narcissist is able to convince him or herself that he or she is blameless, he or she is the innocent victim, and you're the one that ruined everything. Another way that narcissists can react when you try to break off the relationship is just to ghost you. And you know, this can hurt, this can really, really hurt, but really, if this is what happens, this is probably the best that you can hope for, as much as it hurts. And a narcissist will ghost you, and by ghosting you, I mean they might just leave. If you tell them that relationship's over, they just disappear, and they're gone forever. And you don't hear anything from them, they don't answer your texts, they block you on social media, yada yada. And here you are, you know, trying to break off this traumatic relationship, you're still reeling over it, you're hurting, you're feeling a great loss. This was very difficult for you to end this relationship that meant a lot to you, and this person just disappears and just starts another life as if you never existed. And that's very painful. But this can happen when a narcissist already has a replacement lined up and still retains the feeling and the belief that they still have control over you. That's a really important part of this. If the narcissist believes that all he or she needs to do is call you or text you and you'll just be right there, just right back under their thumb, then they won't really feel this need to pester you or hoover you or try to convince you to give them another chance, because they already feel pretty secure in that feeling. So they've already got a replacement, they've already got enough supply from whoever, and they already feel like they still have control over you. So to them, that's all that really matters. They feel pretty comfortable in that space, and they do not care how much this hurts you. That is not something that I think they even think about. If a narcissist ghosts you, I would encourage you to prepare for the day that they send you a text or a call in a way that you would just completely ignore them. That's what I would do anyway. I would be prepared to ignore any attempt that they eventually make to reach out to you, because if their new relationship doesn't work out, they probably will try to contact you again. And so this is if they've already replaced you. They already have somewhere to go. They already have somebody that can give them supply. If that's not the case, then another way they can react to you trying to break the relationship off is to kind of scramble for a replacement. And they can find true love really fast when they're losing their primary relationship. I don't even know how they do this. And this too is very, very painful. It's really painful. Even if you're the one that's trying to break the relationship off, even if you're the one that's had enough and you want to end things, it's still really painful to see this person that you thought you meant so much to, that meant so much to you, that you're so heartbroken over, just go out and find somebody else. Like, you don't even matter. And, you know, post pictures of him or herself all over social media with their new replacement. That's really, really hurtful. But again, this is really going to be a good thing for you. And if this is happening, I would really encourage you not to look at social media, to resist the urge, and not to respond to any messages that the narcissist may eventually reach out to you with, trying to re-engage you. Narcissists will replace you because they need to be in a relationship, or if not a romantic relationship, they need to have people around them that are paying attention to them most of the time. They really, really need that. They don't know what to do with themselves if they are not the center of attention. Of at least somebody that they're with, that there's not somebody in their life that makes them the center of attention. They need constant feedback to reassure themselves that they are important and in control and relevant and the only thing that matters. They need somebody in their life that can constantly reassure them of that. So if you're not going to be that person, and especially if you're telling them that they no longer control you, they have to find a replacement. They really do. They can't tie their shoes without somebody in their life that can constantly reassure them that they're all the things that they're trying to tell themselves that they are. And of all these different ways that narcissists will react to you trying to break off the relationship, it's also important, in addition to understanding that they must feel like they're in control, they also must feel like they won. Any kind of breakup, they really can't stand the idea that somebody dumped them and that's it. They just lose. Somebody got the better of them in court. Somebody got what they wanted. Somebody is better off without them. Somebody is making them look like the bad guy, even though maybe they probably are the bad guy. Narcissists cannot stand to lose. Everything is about their ego. Everything is a contest. Everybody lives in a hierarchy. You're either in control of everybody, winning everything, or you're a huge loser that's being controlled by everybody. There's no in between. It's black and white. So if the narcissist isn't winning, then they're automatically a loser. There's no such thing as compromise. There's no such thing as just an amicable breakup where, well, it just didn't work out and it's really nobody's fault. Narcissists cannot understand that kind of dynamic. They don't work like that in breakups. There has to be a bad guy. There has to be someone to blame, especially since they probably are the one to blame. And I think this is part of that, because with a narcissist, there really isn't that normal kind of breakup where things just didn't work out because you really just weren't a good match and it's really like nobody's fault, nobody to blame. With narcissists that are abusive, or maybe I should just say in abusive relationships, that's totally not the case. In abusive relationships, the abuser is the one to blame. No matter how imperfect the abuse victim is, no matter how many things the abuse victim needs to work on, the abuse victim is not the cause of the abuse, ever. And the abuse is the reason the relationship didn't work out. So narcissists, I think, are aware of this, whether they're fully conscious of it or they're in denial of it. Some part of them knows that they're the one that screwed up the relationship, and they just can't really stand for that, because that means that you won, because you saw what they were doing and you left. You decided that you had enough and you left, and that means that you won. So they have to twist this around somehow. I mean, they might start coming right out and saying that they left you when you are clearly the one that dumped them. They might tell people that they dumped you. That could be a really common way that they could win. And of course, if you have the misfortune of ending up in court with a narcissist, you will experience how ruthless they can be in court. There is nothing sacred to a narcissist who's trying to win and or regain control. And you may notice that many of these reactions are an attempt to win you back, or they come back around to an attempt to win you back or to hoover you. And I have a whole video on the reality of a narcissist's hoover. It's very common for narcissists to try to win you back. in several of these different types of reactions in several different ways. They may try to intimidate you, threaten you, sweet talk you, apologize to you, manipulate you in any way they can to get you back with them. And as I said, that is just about control. It's not about the relationship. Narcissists don't care that they're losing the relationship. They don't care that they're losing you. They don't care about people. They care about the things they were getting from those people, the things they were getting from the relationship, and the control that they had over you. That's what they care about. And those tears you may see, the desperation you may see, the stalking, the harassment, the smear campaigns, the intimidation, all of that is about trying to regain control. And this is a big part of why narcissists can be most dangerous when they are in this window, because they are desperate to regain control. They are desperate to prove to themselves that they are relevant and powerful. And they will do almost anything to thwart your perceived attempt at showing them that you won, that you don't need them, and that they don't control you. I think it's really important that you be prepared for this, that you understand what is important and what's not important to the narcissist, because the narcissist will appeal to your decency, to your emotions, to the way that you cared and probably still do care about the relationship. The narcissist is going to kind of pretend to feel those same ways. And I would advise you to think about the way that this person has acted in the past. How has this person demonstrated to you how they actually feel? How have their actions shown you how they feel? They might be crying crocodile tears now that you're actually trying to leave, but how have they treated you all these years? How did they react to your tears? That's the reality. That's who this person really is. The person that you're trying to get away from is what you have. And once you try to get away from that person, whatever you have experienced is only going to get worse, no matter what they try to tell you otherwise. I hope this helps. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up and comment below any ideas you have for me for future videos. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel if you like this video and would like to see more like it in the future. Until next time, thanks. Bye.